Good evening. Tonight's Mass is the Mass of St. Peter Claver. And in your missal for today, it would be St. Gorgonius. But St. Peter Claver is a special Mass that's said for the Diocese of the United States. So it's found in the back of your missal. In the very back, there's a section for special Masses in the United States. And you'll find on September 9th, St. Peter Claver, and then the prayer commemorating St. Gorgonius is just below that. Thank you. those who just joined us online, the Mass tonight is for St. Peter Claver, a special Mass for the United States. You can find the propers in the back of your missal. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Vitro imo alatali Dei. Ut cune Deus et discerne causam meam de gentilum sancta abomine inico et alosa errore me. Emite lucem tuam, et veritatem tuam, ipsa mei gentit servum, et adduc servum te montum sanctum tuam, et in tabernacula tua. Confitebo tibi in cito da Deus, Deus meus, quale Christus est anima mea, quale conturbas mea. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Intro io alla Sanidei. Adjutorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Dubitur Deo omnipotente, Beati Maria Sempre Virgine, Beato Michele Arangelo, Beati Ioanni Battiste, Sanctis Apostolis, Petro Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis et Obis Fratres, qui et peccata minis cogitazione Deo procure, mea culpa, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ideo preco Beata Maria Sempre Virgine, Beato Michele Arangelo, Beato Ioanni Battista, Sanctus Apostolos Petrum et Paulo, Omne Sanctos et Vos Fratres, et Vare Prodea ad Dominum Deum Nostrum. Visuriato vestri omnipotens Deus, et remissis peccatis vestri per duca vos a vita eterna.
Amen.
Indulgentiam, absolutionem, et remissionem peccatorum nostrum, tuo ad nobis omnipotens et misericordis nominis.
Amen.
Deus tu conversus per vicaris nos,
ostende
nobis Domine misericordiam tuam, Domine exaudi orationem meam, Dominus vobiscum, Satiavit Dominus animam inanem, sedente est in tenebris et umbra mortis, victos in mendi cipate et ferro. Confideantur Domino, misericordia eos, et mirabilia eos spiritis homini. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Satiavit Dominus animam inanem, sedentes in tenebris et umbra mortis, victos in mendi cipate et ferro. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax, in minibus bonae voluntatis. Laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratias agimus tibi, propter manium, gloriam tuam. Nomine Deus, rex celestis, Deus Pater omnipotens. Nomine Filii unigenite, Jesu Christe. Nomine Deus, animus Dei, filius Patris. Qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Qui tollis peccata mundi, suscite de peccatum nostra. Qui sedes ad exterum Patris, miserere nobis. Moniam tu solus Sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Deus, qui ab reptos in servitutem libritas, ad agitionem tui nominis vocatorus, Beatum Petrum mira in eis juvandis caritate et patientia laborasti, eius nobis intercessione
Pace opere et in opi, et animas paporum salvas facie. Ex usuris et iniquitate redimet animas eorum, et orniti honorabile nomen eorum coram illo. Alleluia, alleluia, exorge Domine, Deus exultetur manus tua, et me obliques caris paperum, tibi credictus est pauper, orfano tu eris adjutor, alleluia.
Mass this evening is being offered for the intentions of those who are in our purgatorial society. Eternal rest granted to them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and all the souls of the faithful departed. Our prayer for vocations. O God, we earnestly beseech thee to bless the church with many priests, brothers, and sisters who will love thee with their whole strength, be faithful to their vocation, and gladly spend their entire lives to teach thy truths, serve thy church, and to make thee known in love. Bless our families, bless our children. O Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, seminarians, and religious. Obtain for us many more. Amen. The prayer to Our Lady of Perpetual Help in this time of pandemic. O Mother of Perpetual Help, grant that I may ever invoke thy powerful name, which is the safeguard of the living and the salvation of the dying. O pure Virgin Mary, let your name be henceforth ever on my lips. Whenever I call upon you by name, hasten to help me. When I speak your sacred name or even think of you, what consolation and confidence, what sweetness and emotion fill my soul. I thank God for having given you so sweet, powerful, and lovely a name for my good, that my love for you prompt me ever to greet you as Mother of Perpetual Health. Maria Mater Ecclesiae et Domina Fatima. A lesson from the epistle of the prophet Isaiah. Thus saith the Lord, loose the bands of wickedness.
Undo the bundles that oppress. Let them that are broken go free, and break asunder every burden. Deal thy bread to the hungry, and bring the needy and the harborless into thy house. When thou shalt see one naked, cover him, and despise not thine own flesh. Then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thy health shall speedily arise. And thy injustice shall go before thy face, and thy justice shall go before thy face, and the glory of the Lord shall gather thee up. Then shalt thou call, and the Lord shall hear. Thou shalt cry, and he shall say, Here I am. When thou shalt pour out thy soul to the hungry, and shalt satisfy the afflicted soul, then shall thy light rise up in darkness, and thy darkness shall be as the noonday. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. At that time, a certain lawyer, willing to justify himself, said to Jesus, And who is my neighbor? And Jesus, answering, said, A certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and fell among robbers, who also stripped him, and having wounded him, went away, leaving him half dead. And it chanced that a certain priest went down the same way, and seeing him, passed by. In like manner also a Levite, when he was near the place, and saw him, passed by. But a certain Samaritan, being on his journey, came near him, and seeing him, was moved with compassion, and going up to him, bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and setting him upon his own beast, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. And the next day he took out 2 pence, and gave to the host, and said, Take care of him, and whatsoever thou shalt spend over and above, I, at my return, will repay thee. Which of these 3, in thy opinion, was neighbor to him that fell among the robbers? But he said, He that showed mercy to him. And Jesus said to him, Go and do thou in like manner. Thus far the words of the Holy Gospel. Today we commemorate St. Gorgonius. There are 2 martyrs named Gorgonius that suffered during Diocletian's persecution in 303. One in Rome is buried with the Abbaticana, the other, a high court functionary at Nicomedia in Asia Minor, was one of Diocletian's first victims. Later, the 2 were confused, and the name Gorgonius occurs only once in the Roman martyrology, so it's actually celebrating 2 men who died for Christ as martyrs. Today, the feast of St. Peter Claver, Confessor. Born at Verdú in Spain in 1584, he died at Cartagena, Colombia, on September 8, 1654. He was canonized by Pope Leo XIII on January 15, 1888. 27 years of unflagging devotedness to the service of the Negro slaves justify the signature which Peter Claver affixed to his profession chart, Peter, slave of the slaves forever. Nearly 300,000 of them received baptism at his hands. He welcomed them on their arrival, instructed them, gave them alms, and nursed them in every sort of malady. In a letter to Pope Benedict XII, the bishops in Synod at Tarragona styled him another Francis Xavier. Leo XIII proclaimed him special patron and protector of the African slaves, Africans. While a student of philosophy at Mallorca, St. Alphonsus Rodriguez, porter of the college, had a revelation of the apostolic career of the young Claver and of the incomparable glory reserved for him in heaven. They were both canonized at the same time. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. A few years ago, the colloquium, Church Music Association, that I'm involved in, was held in St. Louis. And one of the churches where we had many of our masses was built by German immigrants. It's called St. Joseph Church. Beautiful, beautiful, gorgeous church. As a matter of fact, it was closed as a church, and the German people asked if they could buy it from the diocese and keep it open as a church for their heritage, and so they do. It's a unique situation. I'm glad it worked because it's just absolutely stunning and beautiful. But in the back of the church, there is a beautiful statue of St. Peter Claver with a big relic. And this is the church in the United States where the miracle took place. That was the final miracle that was the one that made St. Peter become a canonized saint and took place. St. Peter Claver was a Jesuit. He traveled to the New World, the Spanish New World, ended up in Cartagena, which at that time was a major port in the area. It was a well-protected harbor way back in off the Caribbean Sea. And one of its saddest parts is that that was the major place for the slave trade, for slaves being brought over from Africa into South America. And by the time they got there, many of them had been jammed into these ships, and they died from seasickness, from fever, from disease. When they got off the boat, half of them were dying. And the people that dealt with them didn't care. They treated them like cargo, and it was horrible. It must have been horrible for them. Horrible, absolutely something we can't even imagine. And St. Peter Claver, against all odds, even being cursed at and ridiculed by the people who owned the slaves and brought them over and dealt in a trade, you can imagine what a rough group of people they must have been. Here is this young Jesuit in his habit, going around, giving food to the slaves, to these poor people, giving them medicine, praying with them, teaching them how to bless themselves. And he never gave up. Year after year after year, he did this. And he died there in Cartagena, being kind to them as much as they could be. He was the only one, the only kind face they would meet when they got off the ships. So he's a great, great image of that love of Christ that goes out to help others, to free people from their chains and to help them and to cure them and be there for them and to be with them when they die. He would hold their hands when they die. He was like a Mother Teresa of his day in that terrible environment. So we pray to St. Peter Claver for his intercession, that no human being will ever be treated with injustice and hatred and be treated like a thing. It's a horrible part of history, and our Christian faith teaches that it should never be part of our future. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Spiritus
Remus. Ego quod liberasem pauperem vociferantem, et pupillum cui non esset adjuto, benedictio peritori super me videbat, et cor vivue consolatus sum, oculos cui ceco et pes caudo pater ebam pauperum.
ora te gratias.
Secula seculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Sursum corda. Gratias et damus Domino Deo nostro. Vere dignumenus tum est, ecum et salutare, nos tibi semper et unique gratias agere. Nomine Sancte Pater omnipotens et terne Deus, per Christum Domino nostro, per quae maestatem tuam laudam angeli, ad ora dominationes plenum potestates, Ceni cerum virtutes apeato servi, socia exultatione concelebra. Cumpibus et nostras voces, ut admiti iubeas et peccamor supplici, confessione vicentes. Sanctus, Domus Deus salvo, plenus in ceni et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna.
Dei, ecce qui toni peccata mundi. Domini nos in vigno spiritus et tecum eum, sed tanto de verbo et sanabi per anima mea. Domini nos in vigno spiritus et tecum eum, sed tanto de verbo et sanabi per anima mea. Domini nos in vigno spiritus et tecum eum, sed tanto de verbo et sanabi per anima mea.
Ego pascam obes meas, et ego eas accubare faciam, dici Dominus Deus, quod periata requiram et quod abjectum erat reducam,
et quod contractum fuerat annihilabo, et quod infirmum fuerat consolidabo.
Dominus Sovistum.
Domine, tuae pietatis effectus salutaris, ut celesti populo nutriti, eterne vitae coronam, beato Petro intercedente, deliciter assequamur, per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, familiam tuam Deus suavitas, aeterna contingat et vegetet, quae in martire tuo orgoglio Christi filii tui bono luciter odore pascato, qui tecum vivet et regnat in Deo Patre, in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Ite missa est. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat ad Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio ad Deum. Omnia per ipsum facta sunt, et sine ipso factum est nihil quo factum est. In ipso vita erat, et vita erat lux omnium, et lux in tenebre succet, et tenebre aeonam comprehenderet. Ui cum omnis sos ad Deo cum in nomine erat humanis, hic venit in testimonium, ut testimonium, per vivere in lumine, ut omnes credere per illum. Non erat in lux in testimonium, per vivere in lumine, erat lux vera, quae illuminat omnem hominem venit in hoc mundum. In mundo erat et undus per ipsum factus est, et undus aeum non cognovit. In proprio veni et sui eum non receperum. Quod quod autem receperum eum, Dei eis potestatem filios Dei fiere, iscu credunt in nomini eis, qui non ex dominicus, neque ex voluntate carnis, neque ex voluntate viri sed ex Deo natus sunt. Et verbum habeo factum est, et habeo habet in nobis, et vivimus gloria Deus, gloriam quasi unigenitia Patre, in gratiae veritatis.
The perpetual novena in honor of St. Jude Thaddeus, and we place all the new names and intentions each year after the Assumption Mass. All of those who helped to make it possible, we put their names and their intentions up there at St. Jude to ask for his intercession. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Amen. Blessed be the Holy and Undivided Trinity, both now and forever. Most Holy Apostle St. Jude, faithful servant and friend of Jesus, the name of the traitor who delivered thy beloved master into the hands of his enemies has caused thee to be forgotten by many. But the Church honors and invokes thee universally as the patron of hopeless cases and the things despaired of. Pray for me who am so miserable. Make use, I implore thee, of that particular privilege accorded to thee to bring visible and speedy help where help is almost despaired of. Come to my assistance in this great need, that I may receive the consolations and succor of heaven in all my necessities, tribulations, and sufferings, particularly and that I may bless God with thee and all the elect forever. I promise thee, O blessed St. Jude, to be ever mindful of this great favor, and I will never cease to honor thee as my special and powerful patron, and to do all in my power to encourage devotion to thee. Amen. St. Jude, model of humility, mirror of patience, lily of chastity, flame of divine love. St. Jude, comfort of the sorrowing, refuge of sinners, helper of the distressed, special patron in hopeless cases, intercede for us. The Litany of St. Jude. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. God, the Father of heaven, have mercy on us. God, the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy on us. God, the Holy Ghost, Holy Trinity, one God. The response is pray for us. St. Jude, relative of Jesus and Mary. St. Jude, deem worthy while on earth to see Jesus and Mary and to enjoy their company. St. Jude, raised to the dignity of an apostle. St. Jude, who had the honor of beholding thy beloved master, humbled himself to wash thy feet. St. Jude, who at the Last Supper didst receive the Holy Eucharist from the hands of Jesus. St. Jude, who after the profound grief which the death of thy beloved master caused thee, has the consolation of beholding him risen from the dead and of assisting in his glorious ascension. St. Jude, who is full of the Holy Ghost on the day of Pentecost. St. Jude, who didst preach the gospel in Persia. St. Jude, who didst convert many people to the faith. St. Jude, who didst perform wonderful miracles in the power of the Holy Ghost. St. Jude, who didst restore idolatrous feet to health of both soul and body. St. Jude, who didst compose silence on demons and didst confound their oracles. St. Jude, who didst foretell to a weak prince an honorable peace with his powerful enemy. St. Jude, who didst take from deadly serpents the power of injuring man. St. Jude, who disregarding the threats of the impious, didst courageously preach the doctrine of Christ. St. Jude, who didst gloriously suffer martyrdom for the love of thy divine master. Blessed Apostle, with confidence we invoke thee. Blessed Apostle, with confidence we invoke thee. Blessed Apostle, with confidence we invoke thee. St. Jude, help of the hopeless, aid me in my distress. St. Jude, help me of the hopeless, aid me in my distress. St. Jude, help of the hopeless, aid me in my distress. The response we beseech thee, hear us. That by thine intercession, both priests and people of the Church may obtain an ardent zeal for the faith of Jesus Christ, we beseech thee, hear us. That thou wouldst inspire our sovereign pontiff to always teach and proclaim the truth, we beseech thee, hear us. That all heathens and unbelievers may be converted to the true faith, we beseech thee, hear us. That faith, hope, and charity may increase in our hearts, we beseech thee, hear us. That we may be delivered from all evil thoughts and from all the snares of the devil. That thou wouldst vouchsafe to aid and protect all those who honor thee. That thou wouldst preserve us from all sin and from all occasions of sin. That thou wouldst defend us at the hour of death against the fury of the devil and of his evil spirits. Pray for us that before death we may expiate all our sins by sincere repentance and the worthy reception of the holy sacraments. Pray for us that we may appease the divine justice and obtain a favorable judgment. Pray for us that we may be admitted into the company of the blessed to rejoice in the presence of our God forever. Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, spare us, O Lord. Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, graciously hear us, O Lord. Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. St. Jude, pray for us. And for all who have died, let us pray. O God, who through thy blessed apostle, St. Jude Thaddeus, has brought us unto the knowledge of thy name, grant us both to celebrate his eternal glory by making progress in virtue, and by celebrating his glory to advance in virtue, through our Lord Jesus Christ, thy Son, who with thee and the Holy Ghost are one God, now and forever. Amen. Through the intercession of St. Jude, Apostle and Martyr, may you be preserved from all ailments of body, mind, and soul, in nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen.